हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज़ डॉक्टर राजीव गुप्ता फ्रॉम श्रीमती एमडी पटेल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ फिजिकल साइंस एंड रिसर्च आनंद। द कोर्स नेम इज़ बीएससी केमिस्ट्री। द सेमेस्टर इज़ फिफ्थ सेमेस्टर। द सब्जेक्ट इज़ एनालिटिकल केमिस्ट्री एंड इट्स सब्जेक्ट कोड इज़ US05CCHE24। The unit number is 3, which is chromatography second, and its first topic is gas chromatography. Today in this lecture, I am going to talk on column material, which are stationary phases, the inert support, the solid inert support, and the liquid stationary phase or the stationary liquid phase. We have seen two types of stationary phases, that was solid stationary phase, which we read in GSC, and liquid stationary phase, which we consider in GLC. So in both type of phases, we have to use some solid support materials, especially in case of GSC. But with solid inert support, we also need a liquid phase, a liquid solvent in the case of GLC. So first we see the solid inert support material, which generally used in GLC, because we are learning GLC, gas liquid chromatography. So what could be the solid inert support? Because as included in this name, it is a solid, means a solid powder, a fine particles which are inert, which will be inert during the experiment of GLC. Inert means these will not react or does not show any reaction during experiment. And here it is support, means it provides a solid support, a support for a liquid stationary phase, a liquid stationary phase which actually works in GLC, depending on that partition coefficient concept. The main purpose of the solid support is to provide support to thin and uniform film of liquid phase. As I said, this solid support provides a support for the liquid phase, which will be coated over the solid support. So very thin layer of this liquid phase will be coated over this solid inert support. So this layer will be thin and uniform. There are various supports are available to use as solid inert supports. These all supports will be a fine powder with high surface area. Okay, these solid supports will have high surface area, which contains many pores and channels. So the first example is Teflon. See, all the solid supports are in their powder form. Okay, Teflon, a polymer that is polyethylene type polymer, which contains fluorine atoms. Okay, fluorine atoms on it, on that carbon chain, long carbon chain, fluorine atoms present, that is Teflon. This Teflon polymer in its powder form work as very good inert support. Also, aluminium, fine powdered aluminium, may work as solid inert support. Carborundum, that is also called silicon carbide, SiC, इट्स फाइन पाउडर ऑल्सो वर्क एज इनर्ट सॉलिड सपोर्ट. और माइक्रो ग्लास बीड्स, वेरी फाइन पाउडर ऑफ ग्लास दैट बीड्स कुड बी यूज एज सॉलिड इनर्ट सपोर्ट. सो डिपेंडिंग ऑन अवर एक्सपेरिमेंट, डिपेंडिंग ऑन अवर सैम्पल टाइप, वी चूज और हाउ वी आर प्रिपेयरिंग अवर कॉलम, वी चूज दिस टाइप ऑफ वेरियस सॉलिड इनर्ट सपोर्ट्स. बट द मोस्ट कॉमन सपोर्ट इज डायटोमेशियस अर्थ. दिस सपोर्ट इज हाईली यूज इन नाउ डेज. दिस सपोर्ट इज हाईली यूज डायटोमेशियस अर्थ मीन्स इट्स अ टाइप ऑफ नेचुरल नेचुरली ऑब्टेंड प्रोडक्ट. देर आर सम टाइप ऑफ माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स विच फाउंड इन एंशियंट सीज एंड फॉरेस्ट्स like a rock material. That diatoms creates this type of fine earth material also called siliceous sedimentary rock. Okay, what is diatomaceous earth? It is a siliceous, means a type of silica material. Okay, silica, SiO2 type silica material containing sedimentary rock can be easily crumbled into fine white powder. That white powder work as an this solid inert support material. So this diatomaceous earth, which actually initially created by a microorganism unicellular diatoms that generates this type of siliceous material which can be easily crumbled, means it is a type of soft material which can be easily crumbled into fine white powder, that is white color powder. That powder can be used as solid inert support after converting its some modification in its structure. Okay, we have to make some modification in its structure. In this diatomaceous earth, we convert this into a usable with good property solid inert support material. So this diatomaceous earth is commercially available in many forms. These are the commercial names of this type of diatomaceous earth material, which are silite, disilite, chromosorb W, chromosorb P, C22, etc. These are the commercial names which are available in market, where by purchasing these materials, many laboratories made this type of columns. The most important requirements of a solid support are: the first important requirement is it should be porous and hence have a high surface area, large surface area. As I said earlier, the porous the solid support material should be a powdered material which should have very high surface area. Okay, very high surface area, and it should be porous, means it should contain pores inside it, and also it makes channels during packing of column. It should consist of small uniform and spherical particles, means which type of particles, because we can see that the generally particle size will be in micron. So that micron sized particles could be any size, means rectangular shape or rod shape or like spherical shape. So these spherical shape particle are very best for the preparation of columns. So the particle size shape should be uniform, small means should be in micron range and should be spherical. It should be capable of providing a good mechanical strength. What is the meaning of good mechanical strength? Means after preparing the column, that column should be completely packed and ideal. Means during experiment or after preparation or conditioning of the column, this column should not break, or there should not create any breaks inside the or cracks inside the column in this solid support material. So it should be mechanically strong. It should be chemically inert at elevated temperatures, as we know that the column operates at high temperature that depends on the boiling point of our sample, so the temperature could be very high, means 150 degree or 200 degree. So at that high temperature, this solid support material should be chemically inert, means it should not react with any sample component or liquid stationary phase or other part of the instrument or column. It should be readily melted by the liquid phase to give a uniform coating. Okay, what is the meaning of this? Means this material, this solid support, which is a fine powder, should be easily mixable with liquid stationary phase, so it may give a uniform coating of this liquid phase by forming a very good uniform slurry with this liquid phase. So it should be melted with this liquid phase uniformly. In practice, this solid inert support is not completely inert. See, this thing is telling about diatomaceous earth, because naturally obtained diatomaceous earth are not column friendly or this GLC experiment friendly, so we have to optimize or convert somewhat this its property using some chemical treatment. So solid support, that diatomaceous earth, is not completely inert because it may react with, if it is directly used, then it may react with solute, our sample or other liquid phases. Its interaction with solute is considerably when solute size is smaller and the liquid film is thinner. See, the obtained diatomaceous earth in its natural form, when we crush it into fine powder, its particle size is very small, and also the if we coat a liquid stationary phase film on it, that it will be very thinner. So during experiment, these small particles containing thinner films can react with the sample components. So as a result, we get tailing of the peaks. What is the meaning of tailing of the peaks? Means due to this interaction, higher interaction between sample and this stationary phase, the retention time increases very much. So the sample components does not remove from the column in lesser time, or it may take very long time. So we see tailing of peaks when the detectors detect the sample components in this instrument. So this can be minimized by treating this solid inert support with some reagent before use. Okay, before use or practical use inside the column, first we treat these diatomaceous earth materials with diatomaceous earth materials which are naturally obtained with some reagent to make it good solid inert support. Okay, how we prepare is shown here. The proper selection of pair of liquid stationary phase and solid support and proportion of liquid is necessary. Okay, depending on our sample, what is the proportion we should choose during experiment, before experiment, that is proportion of liquid stationary phase and solid inert support. In some cases, solid inert support quantity could be higher and compared to liquid stationary phase, or it could be lower. That depend on our experiment and our sample. So why we convert these diatomaceous earth materials into some more efficient solid inert support? Because these diatomaceous earth materials are a type of hydrated silica. Hydrated silica means in these diatomaceous earth materials, these silica material also contains many hydroxyl groups on it, OH groups on it. These hydroxyl groups which provides a more reactive nature to these compounds, and these OH groups may react with our sample. So दीज हाइड्रेटेड सिलिका शुड बी कन्वर्टेड इंटू नॉन हाइड्रेटेड सिलिका मीन्स वी हैव टू रिमूव दीज ओ एच ग्रुप्स. सो वी ट्रीट दीज डायटोमेशियस अर्थ मेटेरियल्स विद टाइप ऑफ सेलेनाइजिंग एजेंट. सिलेनाइजिंग एजेंट मीन्स वी एड अ टाइप ऑफ सिलेन ग्रुप्स टू दीज हाइड्रेटेड सिलिका. दीज सिलेनाइटिंग एजेंट्स द एग्जाम्पल इज शोन हियर एच एम डी एस हेक्सामिथाइल डाई सिलेजेन. इट इज अ सिलेनाइजिंग एजेंट. दिस इज द एजेंट हेक्सामिथाइल डाई सिलेजेन. वी मेक अ रिएक्शन बिटवीन डायटोमेशियस अर्थ हाइड्रेटेड सिलिका और बिटवीन दिस टू कंपोनेंट्स बिफोर द यूज एज अ सॉलिड सपोर्ट मीन्स दिस सॉफ्ट सॉलिड सपोर्ट विच इज हाइड्रेटेड कन्वर्टेड इन टू दिस एक्चुअल यूजेबल सॉलिड सपोर्ट विच इज वेरी लेस रिएक्टिव और नॉन रिएक्टिव ड्यूरिंग अवर एक्सपेरिमेंट. द एच एम डी एस डिक्रीज द नंबर ऑफ एस आई ओ एच ग्रुप्स. सी दिस इज द हाइड्रोक्सिल ग्रुप विच आर डायरेक्टली अटैच टू दिस सिलिकॉन. दीज एच एम डी एस सिलेनाइजिंग एजेंट डिक्रीज दीज ओ एच ग्रुप्स एंड कन्वर्ट दीज ग्रुप्स इन दिस फॉर्म. सी हियर इन प्लेस ऑफ हाइड्रोजन एटम द ट्राइमिथाइल सिलेन. सी ट्राइमिथाइल सिलेन ग्रुप इज अटैच्ड. ओके दिस ट्राइमिथाइल सिलेन ग्रुप इज अटैच्ड. सो ड्यू टू दिस अटैचमेंट दिस ओ एच ग्रुप्स विच आर मोर रिएक्टिव फॉर इन दिस टाइप ऑफ रिएक्शन विच कैन अकर इन अवर कॉलम ड्यूरिंग एक्सपेरिमेंट. सो बाय रिप्लेसिंग दिस हाइड्रोजन फ्रॉम दिस ग्रुप दिस हाइड्रेटेड सिलिका बिकम्स नॉन हाइड्रेटेड एंड इट बिकम्स मोर कॉम्पैक्ट और मोर सॉलिड एंड नॉन रिएक्टिव फॉर द सैम्पल्स. दिस इज द केमिकल रिएक्शन इज शोन हियर. दिस इज द हाइड्रेटेड सिलिका. ओके एस आई ओ एस आई बट हियर टू हाइड्रोक्सिल ग्रुप्स आर प्रेजेंट ओ एच ग्रुप. दिस इज हाइड्रेटेड सिलिका. हाइड्रेटेड सिलिका मीन्स हियर सम अमाउंट ऑफ वाटर. वी कैन से सम अमाउंट ऑफ वाटर इज प्रेजेंट इन दिस स्ट्रक्चर. वैन इट रिएक्ट्स विद दिस सिलेनाइजिंग एजेंट एच एम डी एस. सी दिस इज एच एम डी एस हेक्सामिथाइल 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 देर आर 6 मिथाइल ग्रुप. सो इट इज हेक्सामिथाइल डाई सिलेजेन. सिलिकॉन 2 एटम्स सो इट इज डाई सिलेजेन. जेन is used for this type of amine group that is nitrogen is present here. Hexamethyl disilazane when it reacts with this NH and these two hydrogens remove as a NH3 molecule. Okay, this NH3 molecule as a gas. Okay, because we know that NH3 as a gas molecule and these both silicon atoms are directly attached to these oxygen atoms of hydrated silica. Okay, this oxygen. So we can say that these both hydrogen atoms are going with this NH and we get NH3 and this Si goes to here and this silicon here. So we get these type of silane derivative. Okay, silica derivative of these hydrated silica. This is non-hydrated silica where OH group are not present. So we can say that now this type of material is usable in our column. Now the second is the stationary liquid phase or liquid stationary phase. That phase which is coated over one solid inert support fine powder means each micron sized particle of solid inert support will be coated with this liquid stationary phase. A very thin film of this liquid stationary phase will be coated over this solid inert support. How we coat this we have discussed in column packing. The most important requirements of a liquid phase for a satisfactory separation are it should be a good solvent for the various components of the sample. because we know that our sample, which contains many organic compound mixture, so for that various components, this stationary liquid phase should be very good solvent. Means these all components should be solubilized, should be soluble in this liquid stationary phase with according to their partition coefficient, according to their partition. Okay, their partition coefficient should be different, but all the components should be soluble in this liquid stationary phase. Second thing is it should be thermally stable, because we know that the column operates at high temperature, so at this high temperature these liquid stationary phase should not be degrade, should not be thermally degradable. It should be chemically inert towards the sample, means at high temperature the sample should only be solubilized into this liquid stationary phase, but it should not make any reaction with this liquid stationary phase. So this SLP, stationary liquid phase, should be chemically inert throughout the experiment. It should be low volatile or non-volatile. This is the very main property. It should be very low volatile or non-volatile, means its boiling point should be very high, because the column operates at very high temperature, so at that temperature there coated molecules our solid inert support should not escape. Okay, these molecules of liquid stationary phase should not escape from column during experiment. Okay, if it happens then the whole experiment will not be good. Its boiling point should be higher, it means around 200 degrees Celsius above the column temperature. Suppose our column temperature is 100 degrees Celsius, so our used liquid stationary phase boiling point could be 300 degrees Celsius. Means its boiling point should be very high compared to that used column temperature. And column temperature, what the value of column temperature we use, that depends on our boiling point of sample. Because column temperature is just near the boiling points of sample components, but the boiling point of our used stationary phase or liquid stationary phase should be very high, because it should be very low volatile or non-volatile. The solvent power of the liquid phase should be different for different sample. That solvent power means solubilization power of this liquid stationary phase should be different, means for different type of sample components the partition coefficient should be different for all the components. Means one component should solubilize in higher amount in this liquid phase, some other components should solubilize in lower amount, so their partition coefficient value should be different. So this is the solvation or solubilization power of this liquid phase, which is different for different components of sample. Now the selection of proper liquid phase is based on trial and error method and from the polarity of liquid phase. What is this? Because our sample could be a unknown sample, means if we don't know what is our sample or what are the actual components in our sample, so in that case we can run experiment trial or error basis, means we can change our column. Okay, first we use one liquid phase, if we don't get good separation then we could use other liquid phase. Okay, that depend on, means the liquid phase polarity actually shows how these components will separate. If our components are more polar, the structure of molecules of components are like this, that these are more polar, then our liquid phase स्टेशनरी लिक्विड फेज शुड बी मोर पोलर, मीन्स देयर पोलरिटी समवॉट इन द रेंज ऑफ द पोलरिटी ऑफ अवर यूज सैंपल और अवर एनालाइट. ओके, द बेस्ट सेपरेशन मे बी इफेक्टेड व्हेन द लिक्विड फेज इज स्ट्रक्चरली सिमिलर टू द कंपाउंड्स बीइंग सेपरेटेड. दिस शुड बी स्ट्रक्चरली सिमिलर, दैट मीन्स द सेम थिंग इज एक्सप्लेनिंग हियर. Means if our components in sample are non-polar, then our liquid phase should also be non-polar. If these are polar, then this liquid phase should be a polar type solvent, polar type non-volatile solvent. So actually this depends on the structure of sample. Structures of sample are very suppose these are very large size compounds, means high molecular weight compounds. So our liquid phase could also be high molecular weight. So these are somewhat structurally similar. For example, in the separation of the water and methyl alcohol, a semi-polar liquid phase is more suitable. See, the water is a polar solvent. We know that very polar solvent, it has high dipole moment. Also methyl alcohol is a polar solvent, okay, CH3OH, it is also a polar solvent, but its polarity is somewhat lesser than water. Methyl alcohol polarity is somewhat lesser than water. Actually the both are polar, so the used liquid phase should be somewhat polar. So water is highly polar and methyl alcohol is somewhat less polar, so we use semi-polar liquid phase, means that type of solvent will be used which is suitable for both type of components which are present in our sample. Here components are water and methyl alcohol, these are our sample, okay, these both are present in our sample, so according to these we choose a type of liquid phase which is polar, somewhat semi-polar in nature. Now the example is given here. A series of hydrocarbons can be separated very effectively by using a non-polar liquid phase. Okay, as in our earlier case, in last slide we see water and example of water and methyl alcohol where we use semi-polar liquid phase. But we know that hydrocarbons generally are non-polar, okay? So for separation of the mixture of hydrocarbons, we have to use a non-polar liquid phase or non-polar liquid stationary phase, okay? Because non-polar shows more interaction with non-polar and polar shows more interaction with polar. So if our all components are non-polar, then we have to choose non-polar liquid phase. Non-polar solutes such as pentane, butane and propane can be separated on a non-polar liquid phase such as squalanes, okay, a type of high molecular weight hydrocarbon, squalanes, which is a derivative of squalene alkene which is completely saturated. So this type of squalene is used, can be used as non-polar liquid phase. See, squalene is also a high molecular weight hydrocarbon, very high molecular weight compared to these three components, pentane, butane, propane. So these are non-polar. We know that pentane, butane, propane are non-polar and squalene is also a non-polar. So for non-polar, we use non-polar liquid phase. For polar sample, we use polar liquid phase. The polar substance is separated in polar liquid stationary phase and the non-polar substance is best separated in non-polar liquid phase. Okay, the concept is like dissolve like, means same dissolves the same thing, same type of thing. These are the structure is shown for squalene. This is the squalene which has high number of carbon atoms, almost 30-35 carbon atoms. It is a type alkene which contains 6 pi bonds. If this squalene, if we make hydrogenation on this squalene, these all pi bond converts into sigma bonds and the molecule become completely saturated. The saturated molecule is called squalene. Okay, squalene or perhydroxysqualene means all the double bonds are hydrated. Perhydrated means all the are completely saturated. So these are perhydroxysqualene. This is used generally the separation of hydrocarbon mixture. It is a hydrocarbon derived by hydrogenation of squalene. In contrast to squalene, due to the complete saturation of squalene, it is not subject to auto oxidation. See, here a property is shown that when we make complete saturation in squalene, then it makes it very, very inert. Okay, we can easily use this squalene into our column as a liquid stationary phase because its auto-oxidation and other chemical reactions are stopped. Means it is not subject to auto-oxidation. Means it becomes very chemically inert, and also it is a non-polar molecule. Okay, non-polar molecule. So it is very good liquid stationary phase for the separation of mixture of various hydrocarbons. Here are some examples are shown of liquid stationary phases. They are classified into some categories. These are tabulated here. Non-polar hydrocarbon phases, these could be separated using paraffin oil. Okay, these squalene which we have seen earlier, that is also a type of paraffin oil. Silicon oil, silicon rubber gum used for high temperature of about 400 degrees Celsius. So these type of materials, paraffin oil, silicon, rubber gum, these could be used for high temperature, for high column temperature, because these are very low volatile or non-volatile substances. Polar compounds having polar groups like CN, COOH. See, if our sample contains this type of functional groups, then these compounds or components in our sample obviously becomes polar, very polar. Okay, because these are polar groups. So for this purpose, we cannot use non-polar liquid phases. We have to use somewhat polar liquid phases. So the example is shown. These examples are liquid phases. This is polyglycols or carbovaxes. These are also high molecular weight substance, but these contains polar hydroxyl groups. So also these are polar liquid phases, which are perfectly suitable for these type of polar compounds which have these type of CnCOOH polar groups. Now the next is liquids having hydrogen bonding. Okay, we also may have a type of sample which have these type of functional groups which may create hydrogen bonding with liquid stationary phase. So the used liquid phases or stationary liquid phases could be glycol, glycerol, hydroxy acids. We know that these substances contains very high viscosity, okay, very thick nature, very high viscosity. So these substances could also be coated over solid inert support and work as an stationary liquid phase. And we know that glycol, glycerol also contains hydroxyl groups. So these can easily form hydrogen bonding with the polar components of liquid, polar components of our sample. Okay, so depending on our sample, the nature of sample, we choose the liquid stationary phases. Okay, here again a chart is shown for polarity of stationary phases. Here it is at top side we see the highest polar phases. As we go downside, the polarity decreases or non-polar nature increases. We know that water is highly polar, then carboxylic acids, amides, alcohol. So this is the पोलर नेचर इज शोन फ्रॉम टॉप टू डाउन साइड वेयर इट इज डिक्रीजिंग दिस पोलर नेचर. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट पोलरिटी ऑफ अवर सैम्पल वी कैन चूज अवर लिक्विड स्टेशनरी फेज इन दिस लिस्ट. वाटर, कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड, एमाइड्स, एल्कोहल्स, एस्टर्स, ईथर्स, हैलाइड्स, एरोमेटिक हाइड्रोकार्बन्स, ऑलिफिन्स, एलिफेटिक हाइड्रोकार्बन्स. सो सी दीज ऑपोजिट टू हाईली डिफरेंस देयर. दिस वाटर इज हाईली पोलर, दिस एलिफेटिक हाइड्रोकार्बन्स इज वेरी नॉन पोलर. सो द पोलरिटी इज डिक्रीजिंग फ्रॉम टॉप टू डाउन साइड. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस वी कैन चूज अवर लिक्विड स्टेशनरी फेज डिपेंडिंग ऑन द नेचर ऑफ अवर सैम्पल और अवर सैम्पल पोलरिटी. सो दिस इज द होल पोर्शन इज अबाउट द अवर सॉलिड इनर्ट सपोर्ट एंड लिक्विड स्टेशनरी फेज. द चूज ऑफ दिस बोथ फेजेस, लिक्विड स्टेशनरी फेज एंड दिस सॉलिड सपोर्ट, बोथ हैव बीन चूज ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ अवर एक्सपेरिमेंट. मीन्स ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ अवर इंस्ट्रूमेंटेशन और ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ अवर यूजिंग सैम्पल, अवर यूज सैम्पल. ओके, थैंक यू फॉर लिसनिंग द लेक्चर.